Those whom it marks early, such as Dan Marino, whose talent is such that he simply can't be overlooked. Then there are those to whom it yields grudgingly, such as Charlie Joyner, who played for more than a decade before he received any recognition. And then there are those whom fame seems to choose arbitrarily and unexpectedly. 10 years ago, on a Thanksgiving day in Dallas, an unknown substitute quarterback named Clint Longley replaced an injured Roger Staubach, and the NFL gained a marriage of man and moment worthy of legend.
Clint Longley is the hope of all obscure players. You know, they come off the bench in a tight situation and go to and have a great glory. He had that afternoon. That was a tremendous performance. You just couldn't believe it. You know, when you lose your quarterback and you're up against Washington, who's a good football team, and you're behind to start with, and you hadn't had much success all day, you don't expect things to happen like that.
On Thanksgiving Day 1974, Tom Landry and an obscure rookie quarterback witnessed what appeared to be a horrid chapter in Cowboy history. Trailing the Redskins 16-3, the Cowboys' only hope was Roger Staubach, a savior of lost causes. But neither saviors nor saints could deter a foe who knew the only sin was losing. When the Redskins knocked Captain Comeback unconscious in the third quarter, all that stood between them and victory was a baby-faced rookie quarterback named Clint Longley.
There'd been a lot of talk in that particular game. Darren Talbert actually came out and said they were going to knock Roger out. When the talk starts, Landry came and said, well, they're talking. He said they're going to knock Roger out, and all we've got left is that rookie, you know, nameless rookie. And then he just kind of would turn his head and look at me like this, you know, like, well. And, of course, the whole team looked at you and said, well, you know, it'll never happen. I was afraid they weren't going to send me in. You know, I was all they had left there. And I was looking at them, and I was afraid they were going to call 3 timeouts, you know, to try to have to keep putting me in, because one of the biggest nightmares of head coach in the NFL is to send in, you know, their rookie. But I was confident. You know, I felt like the time I was a gunfighter with a football. You know, if there was somebody open, I could hit them.
This gunslinger demonstrated a fast draw and a hair trigger release, even though he had not played a down in 1974. Nicknamed the Mad Bomber for hitting Tom Landry's tower with an errant pass in training camp, Longley sighted in on Billy Joe Dupree for his first touchdown.
No, I didn't know who Clint Longley was, but I knew that George Allen and his defense has always had a history of quarterbacks coming in off the bench would do better because they never had a good book on them.
If anything, getting a play out, one of the Dallas plays out, was a lot harder than reading secondaries for me.
He was the very best at looking off. He was a very, very clever, crafty quarterback. I mean, he'd look over here and the ball was going over there and he'd be right on the money.
While Longley was the gamble in this high-stakes game, Walt Garrison was money in the bank inside the 5-yard line. Garrison's touchdown gave the Cowboys a 17-16 lead, a lead that vanished when Dwayne Thomas, a ghost from the Cowboys' past, materialized in the end zone. In a game full of irony, the most ironic twist was provided by Roger Staubach.
I woke up with about 3 or 4 minutes to go. And I mean, I was on the bench. And I remembered the last 3 or 4 minutes of the game. And I asked to go back in there. And, of course, Clint was having a good game. And Landry looked at me like I was crazy.
28 seconds remained. And the fate of the Cowboys rested in the hands of a crazy rookie who hunted rattlesnakes for fun.
Well, I remember we didn't have any timeouts left. There was 28 seconds left. The ball was sitting right on the 50-yard line. And the play was sent in. It was called 16.
Longley's 50-yard touchdown proved more than just a prayer of a pass. It was the product of an adjustment made on the move by Drew Pearson.
He was like a magician back there, and it was like having a quarterback run through the secondary. And it was largely his idea, because it was definitely a deviation of the 16 play. What he wanted to do was make the safety think he was going underneath them and then straighten up and kind of split between the two of them. They were playing inside out and caught the ball about the 3 or 4 yard line and went in untouched.
Longley had no command of the complex Cowboy system. Ignoring keys and coverages, he simply did what he did best, throw the football.
Blaine Nye made the comment is that when Longley got in there, he just looked back and he just looked, well, is anybody open? And he just, you know, threw it. And that was his statement, the triumph of the uncluttered mind.
The game was both the sunrise and sunset of Longley's career in Dallas. The next season, he was shipped off to the Chargers after fighting with Roger Staubach, thus becoming just a footnote in Cowboy history.